Hello and welcome to IFL Science. I'm Eleanor.
And I'm Chris.
And today we're going to discuss the potential causes of five well-known types of headache. We've all experienced a headache at some point, and no doubt many of us have Googled our symptoms and concluded our death was imminent. Thankfully, while they might be unpleasant, most headaches aren't so nefarious. Tension headaches are often considered to be the most common type of headache, dull, pressure-like pain that feels like you've got a tight band around your head. The exact cause of this kind of headache isn't known, and anyone who's experienced tension headache will know that they can happen under all kinds of circumstances, such as stress, clenching your jaw, or even holding your head in the same position for too long. Historically, scientists thought tension headaches were the result of muscles tightening up in your shoulders, neck, and head when tense. But more recently, it's been argued that they might be the result of an increase in a pain pathway activating chemicals in the brain.
Migraines are classed as a primary headache condition. Though migraines doesn't necessarily equal having a headache, lots of people experience migraines without one. But when it does come with a head pain, it can get pretty intense, often involving a throbbing sensation, sticking to one side and lasting for several hours. Despite more than 10% of people worldwide estimated to be affected by migraines, researchers don't really know what causes it. There are well-known potential triggers, such as certain changes in the weather, certain foods, and lack of sleep. But on a physiological level, scientists have been unable to determine much beyond it potentially involving changes in the brain's blood vessels and balance of signaling molecules called neurotransmitters.
Cluster headaches are rare. What they lack in prevalence, however, they more than make up for in their strength of their symptoms. They're characterized by sudden and severe pain on one side of the head, often around the eye, sometimes accompanied by swelling or droopiness of the eyelid. Like tension headaches and migraines, scientists don't know for sure what causes cluster headaches, but it's believed to involve the release of neuropeptides in three key components in the brain: the trigeminal autonomic reflex and the hypothalamus.
Dehydration is also a common cause of headaches. A heavy night out at the bar and forgetting to drink enough water can land you with a nasty dehydration-induced headache, but quite how that happens is unclear. Dehydration alone may cause headaches, but oftentimes it exacerbates underlying medical conditions, such as primary headache disorders or other conditions, depending on the fluid balance. One theory about the relationship between dehydration and headaches involves the meninges, a membranous layer that covers the brain. Unlike the brain, these layers have pain receptors. The theory goes that the movement of fluid out of the brain in response to dehydration puts tension on the meninges, triggering the pain receptors and giving you a headache.
Caffeine can ease headaches, but also end up leading to them, and it comes down to how consumption of caffeine can affect blood vessels in the brain. In some cases, headaches are related to the widening of blood vessels in the brain, increasing the blood flow around the organ and putting pressure on the nerves, which respond by sending pain messages to the brain. Sometimes painkillers contain caffeine. In addition, confers an additional benefit amounting to an extra 5 to 10% of patients achieving a good level of pain relief. It causes blood vessels to narrow, which can help ease headache pain. On the flip side, if you consume caffeine regularly and suddenly stop, that can lead the blood vessels to dilate instead, landing you with a withdrawal symptom in the form of a headache.
While most headaches shouldn't be cause for concern, there's a particular circumstance when medical attention should be sought immediately, when a headache comes on suddenly and is extremely painful. This is known as a thunderclap headache, and can also be accompanied by nausea, vomiting, and an altered mental state. This type of headache can be a sign of something life-threatening going on in the brain, such as the rupturing of blood vessels, blood clots, or an infection.
Thank you for watching IFL Science. Please subscribe for more science videos.